I'd like to invite Frank Kulbrok onto stage from TGS, and he's going to present TGS well data OSDU integrations. Thank you, Frank.
Yeah, hello. So TGS is a provider of subsurface data, geophysical and geological, and kind of data for renewable energies. So just to set the stage, so we joined OSDU about 3 years ago, so 2020, and I want to present to you our view on OSDU and kind of how we our integrations with OSDU in the well data domain. So our view. So first I need to thank Thought Works for their nice and interesting presentation, and also because it actually provides me with a nice intro. You see, I put the vision there on top, and it, in ThoughtWorks' presentation, it was said how important the vision is. And so I actually put that on there before knowing that this other presentation happens, and kind of, so this vision really got us hooked up. So kind of saying, yeah, we want reducing data silos, enable transformational workflows. Yeah, we want in, essentially, we said so 3 years ago. And for us, really, kind of as a data vendor, so the OSDU forum, kind of, so that really has a potential to revolutionize the industry, so because it provides a standard for accessing, searching, and visualizing data with minimal configuration. And also, kind of, it solves a trouble that data vendors of the last decade and more consistently had, kind of this so-called last mile challenge to get the data to the end user in a format, kind of to make it usable. And I heard in this auditorium there were things mentioned previously earlier today, kind of about accessing quality data with low latency, or in the summary of the previous session, it was also mentioned that, yeah, it's good to hear that OSDU actually, that's the feedback that comes is more about the data and not really that much about the platform, issues with the platform. And for people who are passionate about data, providing data, this strikes a chord. So yeah, exactly. Yeah, we want when we get contacted by customers about things, we want to get asked about our data. So why is the data this way or that way? So rather than kind of having trouble with how we provide it. Key trends we see kind of for in OSDU that kind of that are important to us is kind of first, so the use of the external data system, so to be used to keep your data library up to date. So this is work done by an OSDU project team at the moment, and kind of that would allow us now, being selfish here again, so of course that would allow a customer to keep their data library up to date with the latest version of TGS data that is available. And the mastering and tagging that's built in will also allow the customers to collate the data and ensure that they can easily meet contractual obligations with the terms of use. And then the other key trend we see kind of, or we utilize in TGS is actually to directly connect to the data library through OSDU APIs. We actually announced OSDU compatible APIs for well data back in 2021, May 2021, so that's almost 2 years ago. Accessing this data then through the OSDU or with OSDU compatible APIs will kind of give the confidence that the decisions are based on accurate, complete, and updated data sets available. So the OSDU schemas TGS uses, there are four of them. So the well scheme, the well bore scheme, as the master data schemas, then the product component schemes, well log, so less data, wellbore trajectory directional survey data. And all they are currently in version 1.0.0. So there are newer versions released by OSDU. So our aim is actually to upgrade our compatibility to the up-to-date version of OSDU in the master data, in the product component data, reference data. So we are working with the or in the external data services project team together with other data vendors. So the external data services application or service, EDS, so enables the communication between OSDU platforms, so between kind of one of an operator and kind of a provider. And then through, so you can, this can then pull the metadata, master data, work product component, so forth, from the data provider. And bigger data sets, like there would be less data, well-log data, or well-bore trajectory data, direction surveys, would actually then kind of pulled from the provider side. So you actually get linked from your OSDU platform to the provider side and get the data from there. So this is an ingestion test we did in the last milestone 16. So we loaded kind of master data, well-bore geopolitical entity. So where is this well, in which state, which kind of province, and so forth. So in which field, in which geological basin, to which organization does it belong to? Then obviously you see the direction survey, less data, and then reference data, unit of measurement, azimuth reference type, kind of this is important for the directional survey data, and so forth. So the second trend kind of is connecting directly to our data library in our data lake. So as I said, this is since May 2021, so we're enabling clients to directly connect their data library through OSDU compatible APIs, and the content in the API is also mapped to the OSDU data platform, so you can use the OSDU documentation. And here we're using kind of one of the tools on the Open Group website. So there's a Power BI OSDU connector by, well, developed by Krishna Nihil Vedurumudi. Apologies if I do not pronounce this correctly, it's a long name. So we use this and just to prove that our, kind of to simulate end user consuming our data through our APIs. We also have an API documentation for the, our services available on Swagger Hub, which complements the OSDU documentation. So as I said, you can use the OSDU documentation, but in addition, there's also documentation on Swagger Hub about our OSDU services. Outlook, so where do we want to go? So as I mentioned, we want to extend the compliance to the latest version of the OSDU data platform. So as I said, for some schemas, it's 1.1.0, others it's 1.3.0. We want to support more entities for master schemas, so expand actually what we're using. Then obviously, as it's always on the kind of in the mind of data providers, or should be in the mind of data providers, so improve data coverage and data quality. We are currently working on some schemas, so we kind of worked on a raster lock schema. We did a TGS version of it, and we reached out to OSDU, so because we are fully aware that having a TGS dialect of, or TGS OSDU dialect of a raster lock schema is not really kind of how it should be, kind of not good practice, so we want to work with the OSDU and actually have a raster lock schema developed that serves all. And we also looked at a well-documented schema, but we haven't progressed on that yet, so that would be depending on feedback of our customers, whether they want such a schema. So in a summary, kind of, so our OSDU services, so we use the well-log and well-vault trajectory schemas. We are aligned with the OSDU data platform 1.0.0. So we aim to kind of upgrade this compatibility to the latest OSDU version that there is. We work in the external data services team. So this is for us very important as a tool to update data libraries. So on a customer side, getting our data to the end user. We use the Power BI connector available in Open Group web server to simulate and test the data consumption with our own APIs to ensure that they are OSDU compatible. And documentation of our APIs is on Swagger Hub. And I want to actually give thanks and credit to a number of people. So from TGS first, Atul Gupta, who works with the external data services team, Jay Gilbreth and Jim Burke. Then I also want to give many thanks and give praise to the external data services team, whole external data services team themselves, so they're doing a great job and looking forward to the result of the next milestone and the testing there. And then, Krishna Nividuramundu, whose Microsoft Power BI OSDU connector we used to test these things. So with that, thank you very much.